Okay, let's look at the form element. The form element allows the user to submit data via a form. And the form element usually consists of other elements as well. They are mainly the label element and the input element. So this is how a form element looks like. It's just the word form. I'm not going to go through the attribute of the form at this moment because we're going to go through them in much more detail when we cover the JavaScript section. Okay. So, as I said, inside the form element, usually they have two elements. One is actually the label element. Again, not to worry about too much about the attribute for the label element. We're going to go through it again in the JavaScript. And the other one is actually the input element. Now, the input element have an attribute called type, and this is a very important attribute. Okay, the attribute type is very important is because it determines not only the type of data that it is expecting from the user, but also the type of input, such as whether it is just a pure text input or a radio button or a checkbox input. So first, let's look at the data type. There are different types of data, and here are some of the common ones. There are the text, number, password, email, and date. With the type of data that you have specified, the browser will act as a checkpoint to make sure that the data that the user input is what you are expecting. Let's look at some of the example here. Before we go into the data type, there's one very important element inside the form elements is actually the submit button. So how do you create the submit button? Actually, it's quite straightforward. It's actually using the input element. So let me show you. So instead of type as display as text, what did you need to do is just type submit. Okay, let me show you how it looks like on the screen. There you are. So you got the submit button. So we just created submit button here using this line. Now as you can see from the code over here, the input type is text. So it will accept anything that is alphabet or as well as number. So when you submit, it will not give you any error. Okay, let's say now we change the type into numbers. Okay, let's save this. Now if I'm going to type an alphabet inside, first it will lock my keyboard. I cannot type anything except E. E could be exponential if you type into a scientific notation. So if I did submit, you'll give me an error. Please enter a number. At the same time, if you notice it on the right hand side, there are two arrows up and down that you can actually use it to increment the number. This one. Okay, so it by specifying the type as number, the browser will check your user's input. So if it doesn't match, it will give an error. It will refuse to let the user to submit the form. So next, let's have a look at password type. Now, password will take both alphabet as well as a numerical input. The only difference is that it will not show whatever you type on your keyboard on screen. I think we all know that the purpose of doing so is to actually protect the privacy of the user. Next, we'll have a look at email. Say instead of entering email, let's say we entering some alphabet as well as numerical numbers. And let's submit and see. As you can see, the browser will warn us and refuse to let us submit because this is on email. So the email always have an at inside the text field. So let's say if we type abc@c.com. I will let you submit because it is an email. All right, last, we're going to look at that. As you can see, once it's specified as that, you will see that there is a calendar appear on the right hand side of the text box. So if you click on it, it will actually show you the date that is going to be that you can click to display on the screen. Let's say I choose the 1st of July, and as you can see that the date will appear as 1st of July, and then you'll be able to submit. Now we'll notice that this display of the text is actually in an American way of displaying, which is the month first and then come the day. You can change this into a British way or our way, which is a day and the month, using a JavaScript. I'll show you to you how to do that later on in the JavaScript section. Okay, so if you choose a date, you submit, it will not give you an error. We went through the data type. Let's look at the input type. As I mentioned earlier, there's two input type beside the text input, as we have seen earlier. One is actually the radio button input, as well as a checkbox input. So in order to change to a radio input, what you need to do is you just change the type to radio. As you can see that there is a radio input over this side, so we can label it as, for instance, might be email. Okay, so you can have a radio input. So, but of course, you can have multiple radio input. Say this is a snail mail. As you can see, you can click on them. But there is one problem, is that you find out that you can actually click on both of them. And usually in the radio selection, you can only click one. So this one can be easily resolved by having the same name for both of the input types. Say we name this as name, contact, so now if we click on it, we can only select one. Next, let us look at the checkbox input. I'm going to create a break here. And I'm going to create a horizontal line here. Okay. Now the checkbox input is similar to a radio input. Instead of putting a radio, you just put checkbox. Okay, we can create a label here. Say agree. So you can see that you have a checkbox input, so you can click on it.